What's up, y'all? It's SK83 back in my studio. It's Wednesday, so we will flip another song. And this time I will rip one more time a track from Instagram, to be exact, Alice in Wonderland's Instagram account, and flip it. Hope you guys ready. Let's go. And this is it, Alice in Wonderland's Alice in Chains track. And I ripped that one off her IG.
The first step would be to record the audio from YouTube.
Alice in Wonderland is one of my favorite DJs and artists right now. She just dropped a new single. You guys should check it out. But let me show you guys the video that I flipped. It was posted long time ago, last year or even longer, and it was to promote her latest merch at that point. This is the video, let's check it out. She said, "So dropping tomorrow 2 p.m. PST, the Alice in Chains collection. We are fuck me up on a spiritual level. Song ID is me messing around in my hotel room last night. I guess I will call the beat Alice in Chains." Yo, I love Alice in Chains. This track is super, super sick. What do you guys think? So this is it, and only this little snippet of the beat want to make me my own version so I can play it in my DJ sets. And I'm going back to my Ableton project right now. I imported the video to it. Here it is. Here's the video. Let me play it one more time for you guys. I will resize the video. So here it is. What I did was I bounced the video to audio. What I did was duplicate the track, freeze it, bounced to audio, open up RX7 and dragged the track in here. So this is how it looks like, and I used the music rebalance to export me a voice channel, a bass channel, a percussion channel, and a other channel. So I had basically four different stems of the song. What I've noticed right away when I loaded the file into Ableton, the sound quality is not very good because it's a rip from Instagram. The audio quality is really low, so I figured I had to remake the whole beat to make it sound good when I want to play it in the club. So just a short look at the EQ will tell us the clip has not very good audio quality. When the bass drops, sub is there, but not enough in my opinion. And the biggest problem is the lack of high end. We'll see this here. Almost no high end. So I had to remake the whole beat. As I said, I exported all of the stems, put them into my Ableton. I started with putting the samples back together and tried to fix their sound in Ableton from the start. So the first thing that is here in my project is the bass sound. I EQ'd a lot of the stuff we don't need out and added a compression to it. I also imported the vocal sample and also EQ'd all the low end out so I can mix bass and vocal back together. And I also added a pad. The pad I sampled from a part of the song and looped it. The pad will sound like this. And I also used the other channel that RX7 gave me. This is that one right here for all the stuff that is in the back. You can't really hear it, but I've edited it so it has the effects that the original has. Like a riser and some reverb stuff. Okay, so I chopped up the vocals as they were in the original. So you will hear the pad, the chopped up vocals, and I added a little drone pad to give it a little bit more gritty sound. This is this right here. So this is the first sample that I've added that has nothing to do with the original. The next problem that we had was the bass. The bass in the video sounds pretty dope. Fat 808 sound. But because I need the 808 stems later in the piece as well, and I thought it's not so complicated to remake this, I just made my own bass, or just put an 808 sample into the sampler and played the bass line again. Mine sounds like this. Original. Pretty close. Straight to the next important element. It is this chain sound that is in the original. Or I don't know if it's a chain sound, but it sounds like a weird percussion element. It's like a hi-hat type or shaker thing. I don't know. This one. So I sampled this out of here, put it into a simpler. I call it Alice in Wonderland hat. And because the sound quality was not so on point with that, I added another hi-hat on top. So original sound with my hi-hat on top. It has a little bit more high-end and sounds better. The big advantage of this technique is we get the high-end that is missing because of the Instagram rip. We will get it back because of stuff like that. The new samples will add frequencies in the spectrum that the IG video don't have. I remade the whole drum section as well. Let me play my drums for you guys. Original drums. Sounds way more fat now, right? Yeah, we had also the vocal samples in the beat part and the drone, so not too much new was added here. Basically, that whole part is the whole part that we have in the Instagram video. So, remake done. But this is too short to play it in a set. So, what I wanted to do is add my own break, my own build-up, and of course, my own drop. So, let's listen into my break. Has some snare rolls right here. It has the bass sound again. It also has a reese pad that I edit. And I also added a part, I call it a bell. It was in the original file as well. I sampled it out of the Instagram clip. Let me show you guys. And I layered it with another sound. Together it sounds like this. Also high end, so we get the brilliance in the top end back again. So this is all in the break. Also vocal chops again. And our vocal samples that we had in the track earlier. Our pad. And then we are going straight into the build-up. Let's go. Claps. And here you can hear it. It's like a vocal soundish effect, and it's also sampled out of the Instagram clip. Let me play it for you guys. And it's also processed. What I forgot to mention is that on the whole sample group, we have the Golden Vocal Chain by Reed Stefan, sick YouTube channel. He does great tutorials. You guys should check him out. I will link him in the description. I'm using my washout effect again, where I can change the sound or the color of the sound, add reverb and stuff like that. Big shout out to Bassclef one more time. And on my pad, I have a RC20 plugin that adds some vinyl noise, a little bit of wobble, distortion, reverb, and makes it sound more natural. So back into the build-up. And here is the drop. Let's go. For the drop, I added a distorted bass to give the drop grit, to make it sound dirty. It's just layered with the bass, the 808 sub bass. And we also have a lead channel with different type of serum leads. Big shout out to Excellent Sounds from their sound packs. And they will play together all in the instrument group with all of the other sounds. Yeah, and that's basically it. Only the outro is left. Alice in Wonderland, Alice in Chains, SK83 Flip. Here's a drop one more time. Let's go. Yo, and this is it. This is my flip for Alice in Wonderland's Alice in Chains Instagram post. I hope you guys liked that video. I will do another song breakdown every Wednesday. If you have an idea of a track that you wanna have flipped by me, please let me know in the comments. If you like this video, please give it a like. If you want to see more videos, subscribe to my channel. I will have a DJ mix online every Friday, my Airwaves show, playing the latest bass music for you guys, 30-minute mix. Thank you guys for being here with me. SK83 signing off. See you next week. Peace.